do something that, do some rambling about just things that aren't very important, and hopefully you can just either relax and unwind, or just go to sleep, and hopefully this will just be something to take your mind off of anything that's going on. Seen the blueberry version of this, so I thought I'd pick it up. It's actually one of the better blueberry drinks I've had. A lot of blueberry drinks that I find or have tasted very odd. Cider or an alcoholic beverage while recording videos like this, but I don't want to turn into all people to feel that I'm trying to cross into ephemeral rifts sort of videos, because that's not what I'm trying to do. Although he is such a creative person with videos. I'd find it hard to not sort of be inspired by him. But yeah, so I don't want to get into drinking alcohol on videos, as I feel I'd want to turn it into some sort of certainly can't taste. especially when I get to hear back. Hiccupy, baby, sorry. Especially when I get to hear back all the nice and positive. I just set it up, make sure my head is in the screen. Sometimes the microphones are in it, sometimes they're not. And I press record. But I'd like that to be more than just that to the video. And videography and is it cinematography or something? That will be a part of my degree in next year, but it won't be as in depth as about. So yeah, hopefully if you're watching that and watching this, you won't mind me asking when it comes to me improving the video quality. Coming back to one of the first points, I want to do with the green screen. One of the biggest things I'm going to get done with the green screen is the Austin Powers one, because now that I'm in Liverpool, there are a few good places to get like fancy dress things from. So hopefully I can get my hands on some Austin Powers items. And then yeah, we'll go from there. But the teaching one will probably be a good test for the green screen, because it won't require too much. And teaching something I want to get into, and I want to become a so, you know, it'd be a good practice for me. They also wouldn't have to dress up, because you'll find that a lot of music lecturers and teachers and tutors just wear whatever they can. They don't really wear suits and stuff. Unless it's sort of in the dress code, but I found that they tried to go as minimal with the dress code as they can, to try and free themselves up, because, you know, they're the coolest people. Talking about dress senses and things, my hair is actually up, sort of. I like wearing this hat. Somebody commented the first time I wore this hat that I was, see that wear beanies like this, wear it on the back of the head, it might as well not be on the head. But while I'm growing my hair out, it keeps flopping forward and getting in the way, so I put it backwards inside the beanie. I'm also going to dye my hair at some point. As soon as I saw his pink hair, I was thinking, I need to do that, that looks so cool. Because I wouldn't know what colour to do my hair anyway. So, possibly, and hopefully in the future, you'll see me with pink hair. I don't think I put it in the surpassing it completely to the point where we had, I think at the end of the year was 3,027 or 3,050. I think that was the official number at the end. But it's been because of that and the fact that we surpassed that goal so well. It's been quite hard to judge. I've been playing around with two numbers for like goals at the end of the year. But I feel now that I can possibly release or announce the number that I have in mind. It's going to be hard work, I think. Hopefully it will be achievable. I can imagine it. Subscribers by the end of the year. Maybe that's a realistic goal. That would bring me to being on YouTube for 2 years. And we reached 3,000 subscribers with me just releasing sort of thinking 10,000 would be a good number. And hopefully with 10,000 subscribers, more recognition will occur, because I want to get involved with people more and companies and be able to work with people to provide better content, be that working with companies that can provide things for relaxation or also want to branch out into things like a podcast, because at the beginning of the whole this quote unquote career, YouTube career, I wanted to do a vlog as well. I don't think I'd have the podcasts and radio shows. Certainly mental health issues and awareness and how things can be helped in that department. Which is definitely something I'm going to think about. Of course I have all the equipment to do it. I'm also looking at buying a new microphone for, especially Steam.